I'm James Moffat. I've been working on this project for 5 years now. I manage the tunnel ventilation, installation and commissioning and handover. The basic principle of the ventilation in the tunnels relies on the piston effect. The piston effect is basically the trains pushing and pulling the air through the tunnels as they move from station to station. When the conditions dictate, fans inside the stations and the vent structures support this movement, and with the temperatures in the tunnels maintained, this can ensure the train air conditioning units can operate to maintain the temperatures inside the trains for the passengers. So the air discharge from the tunnels is managed in a way to minimise any disruptance or disturbance to the outside public. Those include the air pollutants and the noise. So the tunnel ventilation fans are incredibly noisy, so they need some sound attenuators to reduce the noise so that outside and on the platform they're within a much lower range, so you wouldn't even realise that they're operating. The stations and the tunnels are divided up into ventilation sections. The way that the airflow is controlled between all the ventilation sections is done using large control dampers. The tunnel ventilation system supports the evacuation of passengers from an incident. So there's a lot of information coming back from the control system, and that's fed back to the operator at Mangafo station. So based on the train position, the operator can make a decision on which way the airflow should go inside the tunnels. So basically passengers evacuating downhill in most cases to the nearest station or cross passage door, which gets them into a safe place. Meanwhile, the system is then drawing all the smoke to the opposite direction.